Welcome to the celebration of life of Vivian Monshane James. I am Sarah Wise, a former student of hers during her tenure at Andrew Jackson Senior High School. A beautiful, phenomenal, and talented soul was taken from us far too soon. Her impact on each of us individually has left its mark. Therefore, her death will not extinguish her light, but rather continue her profound legacy. Vivian is among us on today, and her spirit will continue to ignite within us. Next.
Father, just bless you. And I know I can do this, and I will do this. I'm going to read verse 1 through 8 and verse 10 through 14 for you. There's a time for everything and a season for every activity under the heavens. A time to be born and a time to die. Angie, did you hear that? A time to plant and a time to uproot. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to tear down and a time to build. A time to weep. Yes, we may weep, but weeping will endure for the morning, right? Angie, and joy will come. There's a time to mourn, and a time to laugh, and there's a time to dance, and Vivian did her share of dancing. Would you agree with me? So that should cause some rejoicing right there. That should lift your heavy burdens. There's a time to scatter stones and a time to gather them. There's a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to search and a time to give up. A time to keep and a time to throw away. A time to tear and a time to mend. A time to be silent, and my, are you silent at this moment? And a time to speak. A time to love, and a time to hate. A time for war, and a time for peace. Verse 10, I have seen the burdens God has laid up on the human race. He has made everything beautiful in his time, not your time, not my time, but in his time. He has also set eternity in the human heart.
Yet no man can fathom what God has done from beginning to end. I know that there is nothing better for people than to be happy and to do good while they live. Vivian gave us a great example of that. Very happy. That each of them may eat and drink and find satisfaction in their own toil. This is a gift of God, not a man, but of God. I know that everything God does will endure forever. Nothing can be added to it, and nothing taken from it. God does it so that people will fear him. All that we will fear God today. And forgive me for not asking you to stand while I was reading the scripture, but I would love you to stand as we go before the throne. Amen. If you're able to. Hallelujah. Father, as we come before your throne this morning, we come with a heavy heart, and then we come with joy. Father, we ask now that you touch my lips and speak through me and bless your people. I pray that you pray through me, Lord God. There's a time now that I must pray, but I need your help, Lord Jesus, because all of our help come from you. We will bless you, Lord, at all times. We will praise you no matter what. We will lift your name on high, Lord God. All that men may praise you and lift up holy hands to you, Lord God. So, Father, as I bless these, your people this morning, I plead the blood of Jesus about this gathering, and I pray blessing upon each and every one of us in the name of Jesus. May you touch now, Lord Jesus. May you move by your spirit and move by your power, Lord God, your healing virtue, Lord God. Let it flow from heart to heart, Lord God. Let it heal our wounds, God. Let it heal our hurts in the name of Jesus. May you move within us, Lord God. Hallelujah. May your face be shown upon us, Lord God. Make your praise glorious upon this gathering, Lord God. Help us to see you in everything that Vivian did, Lord God. Help us to we will have moments of reflection. First, from her coworkers. We first will start with Ms. Angela. Ms. Angela Smiley, and then her Atlantic Coast family.
Good morning. I am Angela Smiley, a former assistant principal at Atlantic Coast. I started with Ms. James and we opened the start of something great 10 years ago. James was such an integral part of our school and the life of the party. No matter how you were feeling, she was going to make you laugh, whether you wanted to or not. Ms. James was one of the best, and I always let her know how amazing she was, even when she doubted herself. When our principal, Ms. Lynch, made me the administrator over science at the time, James was the first teacher to welcome me to the science department. I told her it was going to be a lot to learn, but I was ready. She said, "Girl, you know you got this." I learned quickly. She was a master science teacher. Every time I would visit her class, I was in awe. She would motivate the students to learn concepts that were difficult and would not let them give up. She would do whatever it took to get them to understand. Whether it was a Beyonce dance to remember an element, or a country song she made up to remember terms and processes. And it worked. I would hear the kids singing in the hall and just laugh. James was such a thoughtful teacher too. She always wanted the best for everyone. She would do whatever she could to see a child succeed. Last year, there was a scholarship opportunity for seniors. Ms. James took it upon herself to ensure the students had everything together, wrote recommendations, and even drove their packets to the office to be sure it was received by the deadline. A few students won the scholarship, and who was right there at the reception when they received their awards? Ms. James. I have so many stories and could go on and on about what she did for her students, but she was also an amazing person to me. She would just call to check on me. She would send a text to see if I wanted her to bring me lunch because she cooked that night. One day I told her I felt like I was getting a cold. She sent me a cup with a small water bottle, a vitamin C packet, and herbal lozenges. All packaged in a cellophane wrap tied with a ribbon. I have no idea where she got all that from, but it was cute. She was just a caring person. She always inquired about my son. Once in a while, she would tell me to send an updated picture because she hadn't seen him, and would tell me every time, "Girl, you need to get him into mama with your cute self." Jane was rare. She had a heart of gold. She had a passion for teaching. She loved to learn. She loved her kids. She loved her friends. She loved her family. Unfortunately, that has been taken away from us way too soon. But no, she will live and learn through each and every one of us. To her students, make her proud. You know, all she wanted was for you to be successful by graduating and continuing with some post-secondary opportunity. To her Atlantic Coast colleagues, a huge void has been created with this loss. Find comfort in one another as you try to adjust to a new normal on campus. To her family and friends, I am so sorry. I know Vivian will live on for you. She spoke fondly to so many of you. I pray for you, I pray for us, and to one of the best teachers, turned friends that I've ever had to supervise. I will see you later, because once a stingray, always a stingray, Stingray Nation, room 504.
Good morning. with her students in 2010. And Tiffany still had this, and so we wanted to share, and it's very fitting. Don't quit. When things go wrong, as they sometimes will, when the road you're trudging seems all uphill, when the funds are low and the debts are high, and you want to smile, but you have to sigh, when care is pressing you down a bit, rest if you must, but don't you quit. Life is queer with its twists and turns, and every one of us sometimes learns. And many a failure turns about when he might have won had he stuck it out. Don't give up, though the pace seems slow. You may succeed with another blow. Often the goal is nearer than it seems to a faint and a faltering man. Often the struggler has given up. When he might have captured the victor's cup, and he learned too late when the night slipped down, how close he was to the golden crown. Success is a failure turned inside out, the silver tint of the clouds of doubt. And you never can tell how close you are. It may be near when it seems so far. So stick to the fight when your heart is hit. It's when things seem worst that you must not quit. So for Miss James, we will never quit. When we had faculty meetings, she had a special seat, so I knew where to look if I needed to see Miss James. And you'll see a little purple chair in the middle with some flowers. So that's where we always found Miss James when we needed her in a faculty meeting. She just sat there, just as quiet as can be, which is not very normal for her. But we're gonna miss her. To the Atlantic Coast family, as I told you on Monday, we've got this. We're gonna get through it together as a team. And it's just been, I just can't even describe in words how amazing it's been to be the leader of the most amazing faculty. So right now I'd like to introduce a video that Mr. Kushner put together. Thank you to Mr. Kushner for that. That's going to just kind of share some of our fondest memories.
Ms. James was a character. She was a very, very busybody character.
Ms. James is the most honest person I've ever met.
When you came in her classroom, it was so welcoming. She made you feel real comfortable.
She was truly an inclusive teacher. She was the epitome of what a public school teacher should always be.
Ms. James just always knew how to make everybody smile, and every Friday she was dancing, and you could be in the worst mood ever. And when you walk in there, it's just like it all changes.
Her taste in music was bomb. Like, she used to make everything lit.
Every time I did go to her class for TV Pro or anything, and we asked her to perform or do something for a video, she was always down to do it.
I went to go record the Poison video, and most teachers were like, no, like, I'm not doing that. But she was all on board. She was like, yeah, I'll do it. Girl, I must warn you. She got the hammer, and she just got right into it. She started dancing, smiling.
Me and her joked around a lot. And when joke time was up, she would always get on to me and tell me to do my work and push me for greatness. She would always want to see the best in me.
And she would always push me past what I thought was my maximum.
When it came to science, I was never a science student. And for some reason, there was something about her class that you just understood what you were learning. She was good at what she taught.
She made everything fun, like learning-wise. Like, if you had Miss James, them songs, y'all can't tell me y'all don't remember them songs.
Protons never change. Protons never change. Oh, protons never change. She was just so full of life.
I was taking an exam for her class, and I was having a hard time, and she called me over. She was like, Shay, come here. I went over to her, and she gave me a big hug, and she said, I love you. And then she was like, okay, go take your test now.
Being able to transition from being her student to being her colleague has been an awesome experience. She greeted me with warm hugs and smiles and excitement on my first day. And anytime I needed to vent to her about what it's like to be a first-year teacher, what it was like to start working back at the same school. She gave me wisdom, and she gave me jokes to laugh at, to take my mind off of anything that was stressing me out.
She would see me walking out with all my bags, and she'd say to me, girl, you need to leave that work at school.
She'll get you right if she needs to. She'll give you the shirt off her back, but she'll also tell you about yourself if you're doing something the wrong way.
We need more people like her, amazing souls.
Anybody who's ever had her, you are truly blessed to have her as a teacher, because without Miss James, a lot of us wouldn't have made it through anything without her.
Here at Atlantic Coast, nobody will ever get us situation-wise or whatever we're going through like Miss James got us. Because she always understood what we were going through, and she understood how we felt. If we needed a minute, she would give us a minute to stand outside and compose ourselves, and then she'll come out there and ask us, like, what's going on? Because I felt like she really understood what we were going through.
And she just, like, gave everybody, like, a mother type of feel. Like, you could tell her anything. You can trust her with anything.
If you was hungry, hey, Miss James always has something in that closet, man.
Yeah, I'm just, like, gonna miss her like crazy.
And she's gonna forever live here, like in our hearts and in the hallways. So we just really love her very much.
She will be our guardian angel. That every day, every kid that walks in these doors, every faculty member that walks in these doors, you will feel her arms around you.
I'm wearing my purple in honor of Ms. James. And right now, I know she would be thrilled to see you all sitting here. And she wouldn't want you to be sad, but she would want you guys to celebrate.
She was amazing, and I really hope everyone heals in their own way, and hope that everyone stays safe.
And prayers to her family.
Atlantic Coast will miss Miss James a lot.
We love you.
We did all love you, Miss James, and we'll never forget you.
Thank you for all the times that we laughed. Thank you for all the times that we danced together. And just thank you for all the times of you just being there and being my teacher.
So, Miss James, you will be truly missed, but you'll never be forgotten.
She would always say, never say goodbye, always see you later. So, Miss James, we love you so much. We miss you forever. And it's not goodbye, it's just see you later.
I thank you, and we love you, and your soul forever will forever rest in peace.
Good morning, everybody. It's sort of weird to really be back here, not just under these circumstances, but being back in this auditorium. One thing I'd like y'all to sort of do for me before I get started is everybody take a big breath in, breathe in a little bit, and then let it out. Do it one more time. Breathe in. Breathe out. I feel the love from everybody coming. Feeling alive today. This is not an easy thing for me to do. Before I tell you a little bit about my relationship, I want to read something to you. Death leaves a heartache no one can heal, but love leaves a memory no one can steal. I've known Miss James about 23, 24 years. We taught together for 18. Both at Jackson and Atlantic Coast, we always got along because we had the same philosophy that you don't have to be a blood relative to be family. And today we blend a life of different people for one purpose, of something that made so much a difference in our lives, for students, the teachers, colleagues, bus drivers, janitors, it didn't matter to her. she didn't care. She touched so many lives. She had such a beautiful soul. Oh yeah, she's crazy as hell. If you teach, you gotta be a little bit crazy. Some called her Vivian, some called her Miss James, queen, auntie, sister, mentor, friend. In the beginning of each school year, a bunch of students called her a bunch of other things we can't say. But she sort of grew on you with those big hugs, that big smile, her big heart, and her drive to always sort of keep it real. She wasn't just a teacher. Nah, she was a gift to us. She inspired, molded, pushed. Yeah, she's a pain in the ass. But she wanted greatness. She wanted greatness for her kids, her students. I did this yesterday, and I want y'all sometime today, tomorrow. If you were friends, really friends with her, and she had texted you, go back and read those text messages. Man, I laughed. Oh my gosh, I was laughing. Go back and read those. I read them for about the past year. Oh man, it was funny. So when Sarah called me the other day and asked me to come up here and do this, of course, you know, I'm going to do it because she's my girl, always has been. So I started thinking about a couple stories. Yeah, I can't tell you that one. No, I can't tell you that one either. But I'm going to tell you this one. So we always had a tight fit underneath our shoulder pads that we wore pregame on Thursdays at practice and pregame. It was real nice here at Jackson. It was a red and black one. Said Jackson here. It said Stingrays across the front. They're real tight. Kevin, you know I've been working out. You know I got to get me one of them to hold the twins in. You know. That's her right there, man. Man, we laughed her out. So we started at the same time at Jackson. You know, we've got the same sense of humor, so we sort of hit it off real well. And, you know, she loved her students. She made fun of y'all. Don't think you know who I know. Trust me, we laughed at you too. You know, let her know she cared about you. You know, she treated you like she was your own. I get a phone call from her. I said, hey, what's up, dude? Coach, you better get that boy. He's crazy. So I'd run up to her room, and one of our players would be back in the pool. And so I would be, oh, I'll fix that, Miss Jane. So he'd come up, and I'd up down in the middle of the classroom, or he'd do the crab crawls down the hallway. Of course, we laughed. Everybody in the room laughed, so nobody wanted her to pull that phone down and call to herself. She was funny, very sarcastic with that sarcastic mouth. And, you know, she'd break out dancing, shaking everything that she had. She had a lot to shake now. She really didn't care. I mean, she cared about everybody, though, in her life, family, of course, her students. And you know, she wanted to make a difference with people. So then we had that chat, and so I've been fortunate because, you know, you guys all sort of got to know her like in her 40s and everything. Well, I knew her back in her 30s. She was a lot crazier back then. She couldn't wait to them Friday happy hours. We did a couple happy hours back then when we were a little younger. So we came to Atlantic Coast together, and we were here about a month. I can tell you this story. She rolled into the office, and she's like, man, I thought them Jackson kids were crazy. There's something in the water on this side of the Oh, Lord, she said. Oh, man, she loved you guys. And, man, we laughed. That's one thing we did. So I'd always try to get my players in chemistry class. She's like, how come I got all these kids and all your football players in here? I'd be like, because they need you, Miss James. I said, they need you for that extra love, a little kick in the butt. And, Let him make a push, get him ready for life. So if you were a student, of her, she would really consider one of her own kids. She'd want you to embrace the struggle of life, keep fighting, lift people up. Don't worry about your faults and weaknesses. Heck, everybody has them. Everybody has them. Live life, laugh, dance to your dreams. To her colleagues, I've seen a lot of my Jackson people that are here, and of course, my Atlantic Coast people that are here. I know we're all a little still disbelief. I know I am. But remember the good times. Remember the hugs. Remember the smile. Remember the craziness that was Vivian and James. And to the family members, you were sort of blended in with us. Don't worry, I know some of the skeletons. She told me, so I'm not going to share with you. But as I finish up, I'm going to read you a song by Toby Keith that sort of sums up a couple verses of what we're doing today. And I was lost till Sunday morning. I woke up to face my fear. While writing you this goodbye song, I found a tear. I'm going to miss that smile. I'm going to miss you, my friend. Even though it hurts the way it ended up, I'd do it all again. So play it sweet in heaven, because that's right where you want to be. I'm not crying because I feel sorry for you. I'm crying for me. We won't be able to see her again, but in our hearts she'll be there. You'll carry her with you everywhere you go. And just remember her. Remember the smile. Remember what she did. And just keep her alive in your heart. Take a piece of her with you. I love you, baby. Love you, baby. Thank you.
But I don't know why I kept going over every day. She had the coolest house. I could lay on the carpet, take a nap. She would be busy doing outlines of preparing for the next day. And eventually she would say, all right, Hernando, you gotta go. I've gotta get things ready for class. I've gotta study. I've gotta be prepared. And so through all of that, I say to the students of Atlanta Coast High School, Ms. James will live on. She will live on in your spirit. She will empower all of us to be prepared. Even back then, she was always prepared. I was in graduate school and she was still in undergraduate, and we were preparing to make sure that the lessons for the students were on point. And we both actually came from homes of educators. And so it would be kind of funny at times to see Ms. James talk with her on the phone. And it was almost as if we were being defiant to speak grammatically incorrect. Ms. James had the ability to say, you better get it, or you better get it right now. And so sometimes she knew that it would annoy me because in our homes, our parents didn't allow us to split verbs or anything like that. So it was almost as if we were having fun behind our parents' back. And so there was a time right after graduate school, there was a gap. And about a 10-year gap, she said, oh, before that, she got a trip. She said, I've got an interview in Jacksonville, Florida. And she said, I think I'm going to accept the position if I get it. So she did accept the position, and then there was a 10-year gap. You know, life gets busy. And one day out of the blue, I got a card, and some of you may have this, a card. She had her own card to me that said Vivian with a balloon of words. And the card said, I miss you so much. Let's not lose touch. And it had a phone number on it, and I called her. And I came to Jacksonville, and she was at Andrew Jackson, I believe. That's Andrew Jackson. She was at Andrew Jackson. And the one thing that I noticed was that her passion for chemistry was relentless. She would talk about how challenging it was at the end of the day to translate the information so the students can understand it. And we both talked about different types of verbs. There are different types of verbs. She had visual verbs. She had all types of verbs. I'm having a difficult time finding the words. But we were discussing various types of verbs. And at the end of the day, Ms. James would say, I don't know what you're saying, but tomorrow, if I have to stand up and get on top of the table, they're going to get this for her tomorrow. And that's exactly what she did. So, I guess we all can say, as others have said today, Ms. James will definitely be a part of each and every one of our lives, in our heart, in our students, in our soul, in our spirit. And we just want to say thank you for sharing. And we all thought that we were special, the group of friends, until we got to Jacksonville. Somebody said, well, so-and-so is her best friend. And somebody said, so-and-so is her sister. And so-and-so is best friend. When we got to Friendship Park and we started listening to the different people, we looked at each other and was like, we're not so special. Ms. James had the amazing ability to communicate with people Two and three people at a time. One is on the house phone, one is on the cell phone. But the communication stayed. Even 10 years later, she spoke with a student from Andrew Jackson. There's so much we can say, and there's so much that we want to say. But I guess the most important thing to say is that we share the love of Ms. Vivian James, and we will never forget it. Long story short, I took the test in October.
mid-October. I got my score back in early November, and I passed. So the next day I go to school, I go to show Miss James. And I saw and she just lit up with joy. She was so happy. And she was more happy for me than I was for myself. And I saw it in it, but to make it even better, my highest score was in science. And that just made her even more happy. And she was talking about it for years. We would have a conversation. 8 years later, she still would talk about it. I'm gonna miss that about her. We had a lot of conversations. And another conversation, I have two young kids, and so when we would communicate, I send her updates of my kids. So one time I sent her pictures of my kids, and she was like, "What? You should too, manage your wife. Your kids look just like you." So my honesty, as you can see, I'm gonna miss that. She called me her son, as she called Benny, and I called my mama. And I just want to say thank you to her family for sharing her with the Jacksonville community. Because she was a blessing to me. And thank you for her on behalf of me and my family, because we all love her. Thank you again.
Very mean change. chemistry song, whether it be about protons or ionic compounds. She just wanted to establish authority and order in the classroom. She had a strong relationship with my mother, but she texted and called daily, and she would always ask me, how's my best friend doing? My most fond memory of us would be being a part of the lunch bunch with her and two other students my senior year. I introduced her to the extra toasty cheeses. She said, oh girl, let me try them. Weeks later, she told me that she was hooked on them and that she needed to give me the box in her lunchbox and at her house because her one for them had gotten out of control. Me and Ms. James shared many conversations regarding friends, family, schoolwork, college, as well as my mental health. I love her as my mother, my best friend. She is forever a part of me, and I vow to continue to make her proud until my last breath.
I'm Dr. Sherry James, Vivian James's first cousin, but more like her sister, older sister. Vivian, when Angie asked me to give remarks on behalf of the family, I accepted, but realizing this is a surreal moment. It's hard to believe that we're at this stage and knowing that I just spoke with her on Christmas Eve. But I asked my kids and my dad and other family members to describe Auntie Vivian in words that they saw fit. And so I'll share with you some of the terms of endearment. One was, she loved life. Anybody who knew Vivian, or Vivi as her third baby sister was called because she couldn't say Vivian, knew that she was always the life of the time. She would walk into a room and just light up the room just from her sheer presence. She was always very personal. And she was very smart. And the words Fernando said, she had a relentless passion for chemistry. I don't know if many of you know that Vivian had designed her own line of personal products. She had her own line of deodorant, of body powder. So I would encourage her to put her intelligence to use. And let's combine, let's create a line of products. I was in the process of creating my own supplements as well. And she was very passionate, loving, and nurturing, and she was always a champion for the underdog. And if you were to ask if she was her brother's keeper, absolutely she was. If she was accepting of all, well, I may not say all, I say most, people, depending on if you were her good or her bad side. And she was always a ride or die. If you were on her good side, she was right there for you. Now, Vivian had a very flamboyant personality, and she would tell it like it is. She would call a spade a spade. And so I also have a similar personality. So sometimes they don't mesh well. So I remember about 20 or so years ago, or over 20 years ago, she and I got into a disagreement. So we hashed out and argued it out, and we didn't speak for probably a couple of years. And then one day when I was going through my divorce, and I'll tell you that story of how I ended up marrying that person in the first place. and she was fearless, and she never fell prey to the term of self-pity or woe is me. She found joy in most everything. And she was always, as young people say, she always kept it real and always kept it 100. So you may not have wanted to hear what she had to say, but she would tell you anyway. And keep in mind that it will always go for your best, and then you should have your best interest at heart. Yeah, and Vivian was always comfortable in her own skin. And to this day, I have a t-shirt that says, I love the skin I'm in. And it's basically based on Vivian. And then you notice the picture in the middle where she has the blue hair? Well, Vivian was always changing hairstyles. I remember one time about 25 or 30 years ago, I was living in Houston, Texas, and Vivian came to visit. So she had experimented with some dye and got some scissors. So she cut all her hair off, and then she said, I don't know what color it's supposed to come out of me, but her hair ended up being green. So we went to the mall, and this older gentleman kept staring at her, and in Vivian's true fashion, she turned her head, and what the are you looking at?
Thank you. take my glasses off. I'm getting a little bit older, so I can't see up close anymore. I got two things on, but anyway. Okay, so as I sit and wonder as the days go by, the Lord says, don't you cry. It seems like the plan is unheard, but as time goes by, you will learn. All the mysteries of this life will go by as a stride. Don't be dismayed as the days go by and by. Just know I have a plan for all, and that's to withstand any fall. See, we do not come here to stay, so just take it day by day. Don't cry, for you will understand by and by. Spiritually inspired, Angela James Riley. So I look out in the audience, and my sister has so much love. I mean, I just can feel the spirit. I feel the positive energy. And Sarah stated something as well, like in the science classes, you know, energy is neither created nor destroyed, just transferred. And she and I were both talking about that, and we are definitely believers of that. We just have to continue to do our best. Remember the good times with Vivian. And actually, I don't even call her Vivian, I call her Bibba. Because like my cousin said, when I was younger, I could not form the phonetical sounds of the V and say Vivian. So, Bibba, I love you. And you will always be in our heart. And my brother down here, he's Robert James. He's right there. Robert, don't say too late, so he's like, okay, right here. But anyways, we love all the things that you all have done. We just love that support and that comfort. It's just really overwhelming. So much love. And the bottom line, if you look on the back of the program, my mom and my dad and my sister are back together again. Thank you.
Therefore, its medicine bestows not only the ability, but the clarity of mind needed to
before self-transformation. Butterflies appear to dance as a filter among the flowers. They remind us not to take things so seriously within our lives, but they awaken a sense of lightness and joy. They remind us to get up and move, for if you do not move, you cannot dance. And I believe in my heart that's what Vivian is doing right now. Thank you so much, and there will be a release of butterflies falling.
Her personality, like when she teaches. Yeah, on Fridays we get turned up.
Before coming to Atlantic Coast in 2010, Ms. James spent the previous 13 years at Andrew Jackson High School.
So when I first came to Atlantic Coast, I was here as the science department head, and it was very interesting by getting a chance to order all of the different scientific equipment, things I've never even heard of, and all of the different areas of science. So it was very nice and rewarding to be a part of that inaugural experience, Go Stingrays.
Ms. James currently teaches chemistry in SLS.
I think that it's a very valuable course in that it allows students to be able to figure out, you know, what it is that they really want to do on the college level, what are the types of interests that they have as directly related to their personalities. It gives them information on how to be able to deal with scheduling, managing their time, finances, and everything that they need in order to be successful college students, because that's what we want in the end, is for students to be successful when they leave us post-secondary.
Ms. James would like any student in chemistry or SLS to smile to help relieve stress off of the work. Reporting for the Morning Rays, I'm Tyson Ellison.
Do you have a New Year's resolution?
Well, I normally do not make New Year's resolutions because I always break them, but I am on the trick of losing a chick and a kid, okay. So I'm going to start working on that. Actually, I'm going to start tomorrow. I don't wait until the new year because it never works out for me, so I'm going to start tomorrow on some new things, that some life-improving skills. It's hard. Gucci, one of my favorite ones. And the first time I heard Gucci, this dude said Gucci to me, and I'm like, Gucci? He was like, yeah, that mean I'm real good. I said, okay, everything is Gucci. South T,
Salty, yes. Salty, I have that going on in my class a lot of times when kids are kind of confused with the chemistry assignments I give them. They get a little salty about their grades because their grades not, you know, what they want to be. Just a little salty.
For me, it's Miss James. Like, I didn't like her at the beginning of the year, but then, like, towards the end of the year, we became tight. Like, that's my home dog now.
Miss James been cool since, like, the 10th grade, man.
Miss James.
Shout out to Miss James.
Shout out to Miss James.
I just feel like her class, like, gets you ready for college because she doesn't play any games. Yeah. And, like, I respect that. And then, but she also just makes, like, learning fun.
Salty, that may be salty.